Hello and welcome back to Speed Freak Garage, home of PowerSports on YouTube. We are now going to assemble part 7, the power supply unit and heat bed assembly. So, I already read ahead, so let's get started. So, spool holder, blah blah blah, okay. Okay, so assembling the power supply. So we've got our power supply unit here, and we want to put it facing this way, and then, see, I think the wires go underneath the printer, so we're going to lift it up, stick those wires under there, okay, and then we've got the M4x10 dome head, and they go up? I think yes. Uh-oh. That's not right. They don't fit through the frame. Shit. Okay. Really want to get this thing running tonight, but I don't know if I'm going to make it. Pretty tired. There's still a lot to do. The wiring is going to be the hardest, I think. Okay, so yes, this does sit up. So it says not to fully tighten, just getting them snug for now. There we go. So I'll be honest, I'm kind of disappointed with the design of the fact that the only thing holding the Z-axis perpendicular to this plane is these freaking two rods here. That just, man, that's scary. I mean, the thing has such good reviews though, you can't really dock it without trying it. Okay, so then, got M3 by, shit. Supposed to have M3 by 25 bolts because of a design change. Damn. Okay, spare parts bag. We're looking for M3 by 25. I think I see them. At least I thought I did. Yeah. This one. It's an M3x25. Where's the other one? There it is. M3x25. Okay. So these will be spares now. Might as well put all my spare stuff, whoops, together. where's the rest of that spare parts bag at? Well, I need the bag to identify shit, don't I? Okay, we'll hold off on that. Well, I have calipers, so not that big of a deal. Okay. Alright, so fortunately we gotta turn it on its side again. Man, I really don't like that. You gotta like freaking mess with such a delicate frame. Okay. And it'll just barely stay there. We gotta get these two nuts in place. Not gonna be as easy as I'd like it to. Okay. We're gonna have to do the little trick that they have in the manual, which is to man, it just does not want to cooperate. See if I can get it from that distance out, or if I'm gonna have to. Holy shit, that's a huge difference in. Uh-oh. That's insane. Is that how out of square the frame is, or what the fuck? Okay. And then no, this one's not behaving either. Get it started and then put it back down. Okay. Shit, unless this is the original version and it screwed me. Starting mid-August 2017. This is September. Okay, I'm gonna have to tighten it from here then to see if they gave me the right shit or not. If those nuts go any deeper, then I have no idea. I'm fucking okay. Yeah, I highly doubt this power supply is meant to do. I mean, this piece of plastic here definitely doesn't seem accurate enough to have anything to do with squaring the frame. So it's kind of interesting they're bolting it to both sides. And I guess for support, but this is some kind of injection molded plastic. It's not 3D printed. Probably has something to do with electrical safety, you know. Okay. So that's in there, and then now you want to tighten these. It said if there's a gap, go ahead and close the gap. Assuming that has something to do with grounding this frame properly. Okay. All right. Check the levelness of my frame. Ah, I can't. Shit, I got so much shit in the way now. My frame is still not perpendicular as it could be. It's about a mil off. That's kind of disappointing. I don't think the printer has the ability to adjust for that either. Well, maybe. We'll find out. Okay, anyway, so guide the low voltage cables under the threaded rods, tie them to both threaded rods, and do not tighten too much because the threaded rods are sharp and obviously that shit could cut your cables. So, and again, what I don't like is to do this properly, I'm gonna have to freaking tilt the frame. Okay. So we're legit just gonna just barely put pressure on this. So like I said, the last thing you want to do is get a hole in your cables or cable insulation. Okay, so then these doesn't really shows them going right here. Shit. Fuck. That was intelligent. Scares the crap out of me having to do that. Okay. Okay, now make sure you're selected for my, in my case, I have to have 110 volt. So 220, 110. Should say, yeah, okay, it says on the board too. Okay. Okay, now we need to remove the nuts that are holding this in place, and hopefully it doesn't like freak out. And my guess is this is another turn it on its side. Ugh. starting to get on my nerves. So these nuts were just temporary. So hopefully we don't lose our belt holder in the process. Shit, it's trying to escape. We'll have to be super careful. Okay. So, repairing the heat bed, M3x8, there's four of them. Using the 2mm Allen key, so not using the large one. Okay. Using 2mm time the heat bed, otherwise has screws, crackers, thread the inside, since the screw should fit directly onto the threads. If they don't, you may turn the white carriage upside down, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so got our heat bed. Make sure nothing is in here. Okay, it says it's gold foil. Do not remove. Okay. Kind of a weird place to have a thermistor, but oh well. Okay. So this has to be assembled like this. So we want that. And that needs to be on that side. We'll have to be careful. We'll have to be careful with that. So actually gonna start the thread on the centerpiece, which the instructions don't actually have you do this last, but I'm really afraid I'm gonna lose my belt, so I'm not gonna tighten it just yet. I'm just gonna get it snug. And it also said make sure that it's centered in the slot, if it has a slot. Granted, that's seemingly a pretty difficult thing to do. It's not going anywhere. Okay. So now I need to attach this. And it says that these threads are pretty soft. So it's, you know, saying it's easy to cross thread them and it's easy to damage them by over tightening them. So So we're going to snug it and then go only a quarter turn. Oh shit, that just unbalanced it. Go ahead and tighten these down. Well, not good. Much better. Okay, now I need to do ah, that's nasty. Okay. Ah. Now, I think from now on we're going to be working on this back corner, if I remember right. So, we've got that. Shit, did I make sure that? Okay, good, that is on the right side, right? Yeah, okay. Okay. Ah, excuse me for a sec. Okay. So the next step next step is the wire management for the course it's going to be a tight fit. Why would it not be? There's shit in there for one thing. Man, this nut does not want to go in. I'm just gonna have to make it. Okay. Really does not want to go in. Okay. Anyway, so do not stretch the black thermistor cable. Leave some slack. So it's saying to take our last little piece here, and you want it to be like this when this is like this. And stick it in. And it's supposed to go all the way through. It sure as hell isn't wanting to. Come on. Damn. Okay. So again, this is like this. You want this to be here. Okay. Now it's going in easier. Okay. All the way in. Okay. Okay, it says tighten it to the heat bed. Be careful not to pinch or break wires. Shit, so does that mean this has got to come through the bottom? This is gonna be a pain in the ass. These wires are not. Cooperating. Thank you. Okay. So, it says leave this wire loose. Okay, I can do that. First, I need to get, where's my wrap? Use the wrap, spiral wrap. Slide it inside the heat bed cover. Do not cut the filament, you'll need the filament full length. Okay. So we're spiral wrapping it. A couple spirals just to get it started. And then sliding that inside heat bed cover as it wants us to, like that. Okay, it's about as far in, I think, as it's gonna get. And then we didn't leave enough slack, so we're gonna pull out some slack for our thermistor wire. So, okay, I think that's plenty of slack. Oh yeah, maybe just a little more just to be safe. Okay, now it wants us to take a zip tie. And tie it off. Do not over tighten it, you might pinch the heat bed wires. Okay. Okay. Now we can go ahead and wrap this up. I think, as with last time, you want to leave a little bit of the thing sticking out. Well, actually, this time it's not even long enough. So that works too, I guess. Okay. So check if everything is correct. So now you got to check if you're fucking axes are parallel, and unfortunately there's only one way to do that without the printer set up, and that's you're supposed to get your axes as close as you can for this. Not so close that you're going to bounce off the bed, but you still want to be pretty close. Okay, so now what you do is you use this, and you look straight down to check your alignment. Now in this case, since I was using digital calipers when I aligned these washers under here holding this frame up, I got within like 0.5, I think, is as close as I could get it. So if you look straight down, I am pretty much dead on, or at least close enough, I'm not gonna fuck with it. I don't think it's worth it to fuck with it. So, spool holders, go to the back of the frame, and how do you, what? Shit, I don't want to be pushing down on it. Damn it. That was a dumbass thing to do. Fuck. Damn, I hope I didn't just move it. How the hell? Yeah, so the last thing I want to do is push force downwards on this frame. It's fucking stupid. No wonder people print new spool holders almost right away. It doesn't even fit. Like, that's the worst part, is it? It doesn't fit worth a shit. What a piece of junk. But I gotta have spool holders, like, that's kind of important. Come on. What the fuck? What a piece of shit. Not like pushing on this frame. There we go. There's one. This one does not have the same defect. So that's good. Or does it? Okay. Whew, what a pain in the dick. Now how the fuck are you supposed to move it to get a spool on and off? Like, are you kidding me? So if I'm going to start with this, then I almost got it on my first guess. Yeah, this boulder's pretty fucking junky. Honestly, wait. Yeah, pretty junky. Yeah, a new spool holder is one of the first things on my list. Ooh. Yeah. Okay. Anyway. What's going on? Ah, crap. Okay, and that is the end of part 7. Thank you for watching, guys. I will see you next time. Stars, I wanna drive a faster car. Nothing can break me.